day. So I threw on the silky and some patent leather ballys. I was looking rather milky, and my partner Mad Mom cooling in the match. You know the one who's on the hill making crazy track. We were driving through Harlem with the sister funk. Had a cooler full of mowing, it was in the trunk. Proceeding on across to 7th Ave. Saw a red bone cutie that I wanted to back. Red and green profile made it a challenge of play. Said, excuse me, what's your name? She said, my name is Sheree. With the mix of a Mac in the game that skipped, I carried on the conversation with a slip of a lip. I extended her a card with my number and name. Passed her a piece of paper and she did the same. Received a call from Sheree that following day. As soon as I heard her voice, all I thought about was screwing. I answered very quickly and said, hey, how you doing? Her voice broke down and she started to say, MC Chads, I'm feeling lonely and I'm ready to play. 10 minutes after that, I was on my way. The first date was smooth, I enjoyed it a lot. The more time we spent together, the more she got. I put jewels around her neck, gold teeth in her mouth. Damn. Even took her on tour when I went down south. Word. It was all about us, no longer single and solo. I bought her fur coats and shirts by Polo. Liz Claiborne in the best Benetton. Wide selections of Gucci and Louis Vuitton. Damn. It was all in the name of love, that's what I thought. But Sheree was a trick and the trash got caught. But that's not the half, so hold on tight. Gonna tell you about Sheree, cause she's too game tight. Game tight. Cause all the girls are game tight. Most of the girls are game tight. All the girls are game tight. Okay, Saturday night, I called Sheree on the phone, but her answering machine informed me that she wasn't home. I left a message at the end of the beep for her to follow. That I was washing up and getting dressed for the Apollo. Stepped to the show with the bottle of Dawn. When I looked upon the mic, my bass was on. The crowd started bugging as the music played. Out the corner of my eye, I seen Sheree. She was hugging some kid, but it was just too dark. When the lights flashed on him, I saw it was more. My first reaction was to just step to him, but then I said, damn, I can't do him. Mark is my partner, he got game, so he took her. I take it as a loss, forget the hooker. Sheree was kinda swift, cause she taught me a lesson.
Yo, man, was you hurt, Trent?
No question, it really doesn't matter. Please let me finish up the story, cause she's too game tight. Game tight. Some of the girls are game tight. Most of the girls are game tight. All the girls are game tight. Okay, the show was finally over, so I followed them out. When they both jumped in the car, it just bugged me out. Ayo, she tried to play the trash, but I was just too swift. Ran to the corner, caught a cab at 125. Told the driver, hurry up before they get too far. Slapped the yard inside his hand and said, follow that car. It seemed like hours before they finally stopped. Then they both jumped out the car and ran straight in the Marriott. Heading for the desk to rent a room, I couldn't let him. I pulled out my gun cause I was just about to wet him. Mark must have seen him cause yo, he hit the floor. Sheree started screaming as she ran to the door. My DJ Fatal pulled up in a Chrysler LeBaron. It was him, my two dancers, and a girl named Sharon. He said,
yo man, hurry up man, we late for the show.
I thought, go to jail for her? Hell no. Put my gun in the side, then I jumped in the ride. He put the pedal to the metal and we started to slide. Just remember this story, when a girl looks hype, never fall for the game, cause they're too game tight. Game tight. Most of the girls are game tight.